45's mistake the other day was that he rushed too quickly into reopening the economy now that COVID-19 is closing in around him. The squatter trumpets job figures built on thin ice but does nothing to protect those about to lose their health and homes. 45 said Thursday's job reports, which showed an uptick in June, proves the U.S. economy is running back, which is rubbish. The Labor Department gathered the data during the week of June 12th, when America was reporting 25,000 new cases of COVID-19 a day. By the time the report was issued, that figure went up to 55,000. The U.S. economy isn't roaring back. Just over half of Americans have jobs now, the lowest figure in more than 70 years. What's roaring back is the COVID-19. Until it's tamed, the American economy doesn't stand a fucking chance. The surge in cases isn't because America is doing more tests for the virus, as 45 contends. Cases are rising even where testing is declining. In Wisconsin, cases soared 28% over the past two weeks as the number of tests decreased by 14%. Hospitals in Texas, Florida, and Arizona are filling up with the COVID-19 patients. Deaths are expected to resume their gruesome ascent. The surge is occurring because America reopened before COVID-19 was contained. 45 was so intent on having a good economy by Election Day that he resisted doing what was necessary to contain this virus. He left everything to the governors and local officials, then warned that the cure of closing the economy was worse than the disease. 45 even called on citizens to liberate their states from public health restrictions. Yet he still has no national plan for testing, contact tracing, and isolating people with infections. 45 won't even ask Americans to wear masks. Last week, Democrats accused him of sitting on nearly $14 billion in funds for testing and contract tracing that Congress had appropriated in April. It would be one thing if every other rich nation in the world botched it as badly as America has, but even Italy, not always known for the effectiveness of its leaders or the pliability of its citizens, has contained the virus and is reopening without a resurgence. There was never a conflict between containing COVID-19 and getting the U.S. economy back on track. The first was always a prerequisite to the second. By doing nothing to contain the virus, 45 has not only caused tens of thousands of unnecessary deaths, but put the U.S. economy into a stall. The uptick in jobs in June was due almost entirely to the hasty reopening, which is now being reversed. Arizona's Republican Governor Doug Ducey initially refused to order masks and even barred local officials from doing so. This week, he closed all gyms, bars, and movie theaters in the state. The governors of Florida, Texas, and California have also reimposed their restrictions. Officials in Florida's Miami-Dade County recently approved the reopening of movie theaters, arcades, casinos, concert halls, bowling halls, and adult entertainment venues. Now they have reclosed them. And so on across America, a vast reclosing is underway as haphazard as was the reopening. In the biggest public health emergency in the U.S. history, in which nearly 130,000 have died, still no one is in charge. Now brace yourself. Not only will the virus take many more lives in the upcoming months, but millions of Americans are in danger of becoming destitute. Extra unemployment benefits enacted by Congress in March are set to end on July 31st. About 1 in 5 people in the renter households are at risk of eviction by September 30th. Delinquency rates on mortgages have more than doubled since March. An estimated 25 million people have lost or will lose their employer-provided health insurance. America's fragile child health care system is in danger of a collapse, with the result that hundreds of thousands of working parents will not be able to return to work even if jobs are available. What is 45 and the GOP's response to this looming catastrophe? Nothing. Senate Repugs are trying to ram through a $740 billion defense bill while ignoring legislation to provide housing and food relief. They are refusing to extend extra unemployment benefits beyond July, saying that the benefits are keeping Americans from returning to work. In reality, it's a lack of fucking jobs. 45 has done one thing, though. He's asked the Supreme Court to strike down the Affordable Care Act. If the court agrees, it will end health insurance for 23 million Americans and give the richest 0.1% a tax cut of about $198,000 a year. This is sheer lunacy. The priority must be to get control over this pandemic and help Americans survive it physically and financially. Anything less is morally indefensible.